Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer and welcome to 2021. Now, every year feels like a fresh start. Every January 1st feels like it's a new year, things are gonna be different this year, like whatever happened last year, that's in the past. I'm starting over, I'm gonna improve myself, I'm going to lose weight, I'm gonna go out more, I'm gonna see more friends, I'm going to be more productive, I'm gonna do all these things. And then the year seems to be basically just like every other year. This year, I think, is different. I think there's actually a chance that 2021 is going to be an actually meaningfully different year for a lot of us than 2020. 2020 was not the year any of us wanted. It was not a good year. It was a historically bad year for many reasons. Like almost none of us was it a banner year. It was not a great year for most of us. For some of us, it was an absolutely horrible year. And so going into the new year with a vaccine that's being distributed right now and everything, and things starting to feel like they might be getting better for the first time in a long time, I think there's a lot of hope on the horizon for this new year. And I think a lot of us are going to really feel invigorated that, like, I'm going to get out there, I'm going to do things, I'm going to travel, I'm going to just be like so productive, I'm going back to the office. Like, I never thought I'd be excited about going back to the office, but oh my God, I get to go back and actually not work in my living room, my office, my bedroom, whatever I've been doing this year, just making it work. And so one of the things that I'm sure a lot of you are doing right now is figuring out, like, how am I going to be more productive? How am I going to do better work in 2021 than 2020? And one of the things that is likely coming up is you're thinking, what apps can I use? What new services can I use? And I made a whole video, or two videos actually, about that right before Christmas with 10 paid apps and 10 free apps that I use myself that I get a lot of value out of. And I think those are great resources if you're looking for just an inspiration on like what else is out there, what interesting tools are out there. But I think that as you go into the new year, an important thing to remember is that it's not a new app or service that's going to make you more productive. It's you. You need to change, right? And so I think about a thing I had about, 6-7 months ago, I was having an issue with task management. I was not getting things done. I was just forgetting. Like, that was my big thing, is I was just forgetting to do little things. And so typically what would happen is, like, someone would ask me to do something, or I would tell myself I want to do this thing. I'll say, oh yeah, I'll do it later today, or I'll do it on Friday or something. And I would just forget. And so I've had to train myself to write more tasks. I didn't have to get a new task manager. I didn't have to reinvent how I do task management. I was just like, oh, I'm not writing as much down as I need to. I'm pretending that I'm going to remember it all. It's all going to stay up here and I'm going to remember everything. And I'm not. I'm just not going to. And so it was just a change to my behavior, to how I write tasks. I reduced some of the complexity of my task system so that it was easier to enter things. I didn't have to enter as many fields when I was entering a task. So that really helped me kind of not get more done, but like get the right things done and not have things slip through the cracks. And this is opposed to the attitude that I naturally have and have had for many years, is that, oh, my task management isn't working. Let me go download a new task manager. Let me try Todoist again. Let me try OmniFocus again. Let me try, whatever. Instead, I tried to take the thing that I'm already using, that I'm already used to, that I already paid for, which is always great, and I'm making it better. I'm using it in a better way. And so that's been really helpful for me. And I think that that's a good thing to remember going into this new year, is that yes, there are new things you can buy. There are new things you can start using and downloading and using for free in many cases. But consider the problem first. Like, what is the problem you're trying to solve? If your problem is that I'm not finding time to do the things that I want, or I'm losing track of time throughout the day because I'm just working at home, I'm in the office all day and there's no structure to my day, maybe start using the calendar app on your phone. Maybe whatever device you're watching this on right now probably has a free calendar app on it. Start using a calendar in the first place. Don't look for a paid subscription or some premium calendar right off the bat. Use the free one and see if that works for you, and then go from there. But I think that we too often, myself included, I'm really speaking for myself here, so I'm not trying to project. I'm really just saying, this is me. When I see a problem, I'm often looking towards what's the thing I can buy to make this better. And that's not the right solution, right? Sometimes that is the thing you need to do because you need more power, you need more functionality, you need some feature. But in many cases, you already have the functionality you need. You already have the features you need. It's just a matter of using them. So look inside first, figure out what you're doing wrong that you can improve, and then go out and buy something, download something, whatever, if that's something that you think you need to do. But I think that starting from that, I need to download something to fix my problem, is the wrong direction. So flip it around. I think that's a good thing for 2021 to keep in mind as you're trying to do better, you're trying to be more productive, or just do better work, not necessarily do more, just do better work. That's what I would recommend going into the new year. If you have never seen this channel before, I hope you like the video. I hope you subscribe, tell your friends, all that good stuff. If you have subscribed already, thank you so much for watching through 2020. This was a new project. I had never really done YouTube like this before, so this is all a new experience for me, and I'm learning along the way. In 2021, I'm looking to do a lot more of this channel. I hope to have better content for you. I hope to have more dynamic content where I can maybe leave this office and do videos elsewhere to mix it up a little bit more. But if there's anything you want to see from the channel, always let me know in the comments. I try to read every comment, even if I don't get to respond to every single one. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you here next time on A Better Computer.